I got some very special people I got to introduce to you. So, let me begin by introducing the mother of the groom, Nancy Hagen, everybody. Mrs. Lance and Michelle Ketchum. Put your hands together next for Tyler and Morgan Devin. And Katie Cardner. Now let's have a big round of applause for Trevor Hash and Laura Saunders.
Only you can love me this way. Let's hear it for Paul and Jen, everybody.
My name is Chris. I am Brianne's older brother. I know you know what that means. Gotcha. I'm sorry I had to be at your wedding, but it had to be done. So get ready for this little ditty. Back about 7 years ago when I graduated from the Fire Academy, my mother, who's over there in the blue, went up to the chief of the Auburn Fire Department and introduced herself and said, "Hi, I'm Nancy. I'm Polly's mom." And without skipping a beat, the chief of the fire department said, "Oh, that's nice. I bet you're Chris's mom's too." Charlotte, I love you, okay? So I don't do this public speaking thing very well, so I'd kind of use this week to determine how much Jack Daniels I should drink before I got here. I practiced every single day. I will say, do not do it at work because apparently that is completely frowned upon. Well, here we are 14 years later from when Polly and Jen first met. You know. So when Jen got demoted from the smart people math class down to the normal people math class, it turns out Jen was only one good math test away from never meeting Polly. So 3,389 days ago when I got married, or 4,880,160 minutes ago for you trying to figure out how long ago that was when my wife and I got married, Polly had to do a speech to about 19 people. Do you see how many people are here right now, Polly? It's not, you kind of screwed me on this one. So everybody has that time in their life when they meet their one true love, the one person they adore more than anything. For Polly, that was August 10th, 1993, when he opened his big blue eyes and he met me. Like I said before, I'm Chris. I'm Polly's older brother. I taught him everything that he knows except for golf. He's been kicking my ass since he was about 5 years old. He is so, I'm going to talk about your dad here for a minute. He wouldn't have missed this for the world, and he still isn't missing it. He is so proud of the man that you are. And I've never seen somebody light up more than he would when he would talk about you, especially you and your goddamn golf. Some of my best memories would be Wednesday nights at Arrowhead, always coming in last place. Even though I constantly lost, I would never trade those moments watching Paulie get better and better every single year. There was a time I did beat Paulie, though. It was in my mom's kitchen where he, where his teenage attitude kind of got the best of him. And he kind of puffed up his chest, and I quickly deflated him, like Tom Brady's football. And he's been nothing but a complete angel ever since. Just ask my mother. Now, Jennifer. Doesn't the bride look absolutely beautiful tonight, everybody? I love this girl. She's been nothing but amazing ever since the day I met her. You guys have been the best of friends for a very long time, and the amount of things you guys have experienced have taken some people decades. And it has nothing but turn your guys' relationship into a beautiful marriage. The first time I ever met Jen was up at Old Forge. There definitely was not any underage drinking there. Lance, Michelle, I swear, I promise. If there was, Nancy had something to do with it. I got your back. Jen, thank you for telling us how much you loved Polly time after time after time after time. Anybody who wants to hear about this story, we can talk about it later. No matter what the future holds, seeing how well you take care of each other and seeing how well and how good of parents you are to Marvel. I know no matter what you guys do together, you guys are going to be fantastic. I would like to thank Lance and Michelle for taking the time to raise such a wonderful daughter. And I would like to thank my mom and pa for giving me the little brother that I always wanted. Don't be afraid to put your queen on a pedestal, and don't be afraid to put your king on a pedestal. And don't treat the next week like a honeymoon. Treat every day like it's going to be a honeymoon. Now, one last thing. I'm a girl dad times three to Mallory, my fashionista, Ava, and my little comedic genius, Charlotte. So, Polly, if you could take a few seconds tonight and bring me a nephew, I would appreciate it greatly. I love you guys, and thank you for all making all of us a part of your special day. Jen, I really dig your foundation. Let's celebrate. Cheers.
No, I want to thank everybody for coming. I usually do this type of thing at a charity golf tournament, so the thank yous, first of all, a little story and then a toast. How does that sound? So thank you all. Without you, this couldn't be possible. So thank you for making that extra effort on a Friday afternoon to get yourselves here to this beautiful event center. Thank Alicia and her family for organizing and preparing and doing all the work. An announcement before I forget. If you do have too much to drink, or, you know, we're not encouraging that by any means, but there is a transportation bus that's going to get us from here over to Vernon Downs. So leave your cars here. That's perfectly fine with the owners. We'll figure out a way to get them back. Want to meet you all for brunch if you're staying over. That would be great. Want to thank my wife, Michelle, for putting so much work into this event. And her sister, Nicole. It's always helpful to have a wedding planner in the family. Thank you very much. And I'd like to thank God for holding off on the weather and the rain for just a little bit longer. It was raining at the house this morning, and we're kind of freaking out a little bit. But I called Michelle, and she's like, nope, it's fine here. Don't worry about it. So that worked out. Thank you. Thank you, God. So I want to talk a little bit about all life's little decisions and things that happen, and it's kind of like what Chris was saying, but think about those things that for 5 minutes makes a difference. Michelle left the house dark 30 this morning, and then about 15 minutes later, I hear the engine running, and oh, forgot my coffee. Well, think if you had gone down the road and you came upon an accident, that if you had continued on and missed that time, you might have been involved in that. Or if you're in line for the lottery and you know you're polite and you let someone ahead of you and they win the lottery on the scratch off and you're stuck with nothing. I think we can all relate to those type of events, and certainly Jen and Paul can, right? I mean, when they met back in eighth grade, is that right? That's how long they've known each other. It's amazing. But we moved away in ninth grade, so, you know, that's the end of that story, right? But, no, it was kind of interesting that they both happened to join their school rowing teams. And Jen was normally, what position, Jen? Main, a rower. But her mother decided to take her down the expert slope because it wasn't labored properly, and she blew her knee out, and so now she had to steer the boat. So think about it. If some of that stuff happened, you couldn't have aimed your boat at Paul's boat and crashed into him. And like I like to say, you know, it was the female version of, hey, how you doing, huh? But, you know, and that was before you could slide into DMs. It was before Facebook. I think it was MySpace back then, right? And so, you know, they reconnected, which was fantastic. And, you know, we thought Polly was just a friend, you know, he's always hanging around and always on the on the video chats and, you know, Jen with her girlfriends and, oh, yeah, let's have Paul over. That'd be great, you know. And, you know, Eric's a great judge of character. And he's like, yeah, Paul's nice. Yeah, he's a nice guy. And our dog Riley would bite anybody that got too close to Jen, but she actually liked Paul. So, you know, automatically he's in, right? So, so then they came up to us a little while later, and they're like, we got a big announcement. I'm like, what do you mean? Oh, we're dating. And Michelle and I are like, yeah, we know. So there goes the surprise. Sorry about that. So Jen asked her mom, how will I know who the right man for me is? And her response was, excuse me, whew, thought I was going to do all right here. If you marry your best friend, you won't have to worry about it. And today she did. So what can I say about Paul? Well, he's kind to animals. And he's generous when it comes to gimme putts. Appreciate those 10-footers, Paul. Thank you. You know, he's thoughtful. He loves Jen. We all know that. And he's respectful. He came up to me, and you could tell he was sweating. Oh, my God. I never seen this look on his face before. And he's like, there's something I need to ask you. And I'm like, okay, this should be good, right? This is good. So he's like, I want to ask Jen to marry me. And I was like, well. So I let him sweat it out just in the silence for a little while. And I go, yeah, I guess that'd be all right. So that was, I don't know about you, but that was a fun moment for me. So Paul, welcome to our family. Jennifer, you have your best friend for life. So can we have a little toast? Are we ready to toast? So remember this day, like the officiant said, you know, all your friends and family are around you to support you now and in the future. And we just look forward so much to your love and happiness. Cheers. Love you.
Dear God, we are gathered here today to celebrate Jen and Paul's everlasting love for each other. We pray for your blessing on their commitment to each other, and we pray that your grace and peace will rest on their future life together. Please watch over everyone here today, family, friends, and staff, that they are happy and healthy. We ask for your blessing on this first meal that they share together as husband and wife. May you, our Heavenly Father, lead and direct their path. They always keep Jesus at the center of their lives. Bless us all as we share the celebratory meal together. May your love and grace rest on each person here. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Please pray with me. Bless us, O Lord, for these thy gifts, which you're about to receive from thy bounty through Christ our Lord. Amen. Father's
two things I know for sure. She was sent here from heaven, and she's daddy's little girl. As I drop to my knees by her bed at night, she talks to Jesus, and I close my eyes, and I thank God for all of the joy in my life. Oh, but most of all, for butterflies.
Love, you're alone in this place. Thank you. All the chaps. Well, everybody.
Thank you
so much for coming.
Thank you.
I think about the girl up in the sky. And up in the air, I'm gonna come.
power of the sun in the palm of my hand.
For now, man. My just a little bit of
He's watching me nerd out.